Hey, welcome back to Just a Wrenchin'. I'm Kevin. If you're just joining us, I've got some other videos on the channel that you'd like to take a look. The majority of the project is on a 2006 Pontiac Torrent. There's some variations between Fords, you know, Mustang, Tauruses, to Chevy Impalas, you know, stuff, things of that nature. So, like I said, welcome back. We are doing, we're doing valve cover gaskets. Let me get this where I can see, okay? If you can look right, right down, where am I at? Right down over, okay, I'm gonna have to take you this way. Look. Right down over here, we got a bunch of oil. And it's all coming from this valve cover. So when a customer states, smoking from the engine, and you go to investigate, and you find oil all on that back side. Not necessarily on the bottom side. And you begin to suspect it's valve cover, and voila, you find that all the oil is leaking out from the valve cover gasket. When there's no other evidence, then up top, you go right to the valve cover. So, we're going to start today. You guys can still see. Okay, we're going to start today. I'm going to start today with a series of 10 mils, including the valve cover itself as 10 mils. First and foremost, we're going to pull these coils. Now there's a gray connector you got to pull up and then push down, and voila, it comes off pretty easy. Pull up the gray tab, push down on the middle tab, voila. Okay, now that those are connected, disconnected, it's the opposite of being connected. Okay, this rail is that harness for those coils, which are also 10 mil. There's two of them, one right here and one right here. We're gonna take those off and we're gonna bring it up out of our way. So, here goes nothing. Loosen them up. You should get a bolt tray. Okay. Which you have for a channel. Okay, I've got the oil draining. This customer also wanted to change the oil. She's black. Blacker than the black sea. But it's really not that black. The sea itself isn't that black. It's just, you can't see further than so many feet. That's why they call it the black sea. Now we're gonna lift this up. Move it out of our way. See how easy that was? Can you see? Oh my God. I'm a bad cameraman. See, I can lift this away now, move it up and out of our way. Not too much because, you know, the harness is set where it wants to sit. So we had quite a bit of debris down inside here. We vacuumed and then we made sure the dipstick was in, the cap was on tight, and we took 90 pounds of PSI air and we blew it all out. So we can have a particle-free removal on the dob cover, because this under here is the direct transport to the inside of your engine. Okay, so we got 10 mils on the coils. Crack those loose. Okay, we're gonna check the conditions of the spark plugs as well to make sure they are not oil fouled. Let's cross our fingers and hope. Okay. Pull these out. Between the harness rail and all the rest of these bolts are different. Let me show you what I mean. There's the bolt for the coils, and they're probably going to be the same around the valve cover. This is the bolt for the harness. They're different. This top piece, you can leave it on. That's just for the engine cover. We don't need to remove it. And they all are the same length. Same size, same shape, same color, same length. They're identical. Okay. Now let's pop these out one by one. So far, what do you think? That oil or what? Oil soaked? Is that too much? What do you guys think? Do you think it's too much oil? Nah, it's just around the edges. It still starts fine. We're gonna keep these in order. That's the one. So we'll put this one like right under the camera, right there. Let's do second. Ooh, this one's a whole lot better. Hardly any oil whatsoever. Okay. We'll give it a wipe down. Okay, that's number two. We'll set that next. Then three. Yeah, about the same. Little bit of oil around the middle part. Not bad, just a little ring. We'll set that on the third spot. Then number four. Yeah, same condition. So, yeah, it's okay. So, okay, so about 10 minutes in, we've already got the harness out of the way, we've got the oil draining, we have the coils out, and next up is the spark plugs. For that, I'm going to need the 5/8. Let me see. I have
5/8
right here, which is 3/8 socket adapter. Okay. Now, down here, is it the 5/8? Ooh. There is some oil down there. I don't think it's the 5/8. Okay. Maybe it's too big. Not grabbing. Okay. We're just gonna have to. So, I don't need it right now. If you guys are heading over there,
we're gonna go clean it.
Yeah, I would say spray it. Use the air to spray it up. Okay.
We're gonna take it off and make sure they spark.
Put it about 90 psi. That'll blow away some of the rats. As we're trying to figure out, see, I got a 16. Ooh, nice. 16. Spark plugs are 16. Okay. Feels good. There's oil in this one. When are you guys heading over? It wasn't much. That's loose.
go down on the piston. That'll clean out with the gas. You can also I'd say it's like 10 millimeters. How did I say it? My syringe? Is it millimeters? Yeah. Milliliters, yeah. Maybe less. Maybe about 5.
Okay, so
do you have
a
quarter of
a
can? Yeah.
Big.
16. Yep. So we get a magnet. Yeah. I have to switch the nozzle. So all right. Yeah. There's this first spark plug. I can clean it the best I can. Check the gap, make sure it's good. Then I'll stick the, see, that's what I need, the air. I can stick that air nozzle down there and down that cylinder. And then you stick a towel around it and just blow. Dang. It looked all right for being gapped. Good. We'll keep the spark plugs in order too. So I'll get the rest of these pulled out and we'll continue on. Hey, before we get to starting, all the spark plugs are out anyway, by the way. The number one cylinder had oil, which means that this corner right here is the failure for the gasket. It's all built up right around here, and we're getting oil up on the heat shield. But before we start to go loosen up all these bolts, the perimeter bolts, there's a couple hoses. One of them is right here. Another one is back here. So we got to disconnect those. Okay, now I can pull those off. Well, gotta break them free. Grab yourself a needle nose, squeeze gently where the fitting is, and just give it some turns. That'll help break it free. See? Nice and easy. Now I can pull it off. There you go. There's the first hose right here. Same thing on the other. Grab it. Twist. Now I'll break it free. Okay. Now I can pull it off. There you go. That's for the air box. Okay. That's off. And out of our way. Break some of these loose. We're going to start with the center on the inside. And we're going to work out. We're just going to break them free. Start with the center. Move around. Middle bolts. Okay. I need the light again. Now the outside. That one looks loose. Oh my god. When going around the outside, start with the middle, then work out. There we go. Okay. Now that all those are loose, you can take them out. These are shanked. These are shanked bolts. The ones on the outside. Yep. The ones on the inside are also shanked. Get this thing turned around so I can see the heck I'm doing. These are all 10 millimeter, like I said. The majority, if not all, are 10 millimeter. And you got a tight spot, you can use a magnet. I'm over here. Can you see it? Probably not. If you can't grab it with your hand, stick a magnet to your socket when you're done unscrewing it. Okay, let me point you up a little bit. Right there. Oh, geez. Bad camera. Let's see. I'm over here in this corner, so I'm done. Stick a magnet to it, and it'll help pull your bolt right out. Maybe. Well, they made a liar out of me. So, anyway, my hands were just fine.
I was able to get in there with my hands. It would have been a cool trick though, huh? All those need cleaned. Oh, I forgot one. Right in here. That looks like a case for a wobbly 10 mil. So, we're gonna have to pull out. The wobbly. Because it's right here by the engine harness mount when you're pulling an engine. Probably might have to pull this mount off. Just to get to that one. Let's see if there's another one back here that I missed. No. This has got a lot of crud. Well, All right, we're going with a shallow 10 mil.
Jesus.
Oh, you still got a little bit of dirt back there. I got it. Okay. Don't go too high with it, because that tube connection's right there. So you're gonna have to get the rest with, let's see, maybe I can turn it with a magnet. No. All right, 10 mil open end. Let me see if I got one.
What the heck is that? Oh, my tea. Jeez.
The hardest bolt to get to you. Right here. Oh, a turn with the magnet. Things you gotta come up with just to try to get one bolt out. Okay, let's go with the old two-finger operation. That never fails. The old two-finger. And of course, you need a wrench. A combination of a wrench and your fingers. Go. Last bolt. Right there. Wow. That's a total of 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18. 18, I'd say. Okay. Nice to be able to pick this up. Move that out of the way. I don't know if these go all the way down inside the valve, I don't know. Yeah.
I think those, that engine cover mount bar needs to come off because it looks like it's got some pretty long bolts. Those are 10 as well. No, they're shorties. They don't go all the way down. So I just gotta pry. Let's get a flat tool. Let's go back. Okay. We're gonna pull this up. Flat tool right here. It's a little flat tool. I get up in here and pry just like that. I did so in the back and we just lift it. And we got these wire. These wire keepers right here. There you go. They just pop out of the holes. So that's all you gotta do. That should be loose enough to get this up. She's up. Get the other one up out of here. Just going along with this flat tool. Ooh. Yeah, don't.
term. And it's a zip tie type of deal. From this. Okay. That connector, take that off. Then voila. She's off. Okay. I'll bring it around to show you. All right. Grab a light. Underside. Zoom out first. There we go. Okay. There's the underside. One more little segment before I end this video. There's your break right there. That's what caused all that oil. And this is the corner where it was all sludgy. So we're going to get this regasketed, cleaned up. And we got the surface all wiped down. All the surfaces all wiped down. One more thing is this brake right here is going to get RTV right here. And we're going to put RTV right here because that's the timing cover gasket. Then we'll put this on and give her oil and send her on her way. Thank you for watching this video. I did this. So can you. We'll see you in the next one.